Are those probiotic drinks you buy actually worth the money, and do they actually make any difference to you if you have Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis? Well, stay tuned as I'll be discussing both pro and prebiotics in this video, how they work and how they relate to inflammatory bowel disease, and telling you where you can get my free nutrition and IBD ebook. Welcome back to my channel, the only place for Crohn's and colitis tips, tricks and information. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified every time I post a video. And if you want to join an exclusive community of people who receive my personal tips and tricks on living with Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, then make sure you sign up to my newsletter by hitting the link in the description box below. And to find out how you can get your hands on this free ebook, stick around to the end of the video. Okay, so before we get started, if you have Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis and are thinking of either changing your diet or maybe even taking some supplementations, please go and speak to your doctor, who will be able to refer you to a dietitian that will guide you through the most suitable diet for you to go on. Right, so we'll start off with probiotics. Now, probiotics is the name given to good bacteria which is found in food or food supplements. Now, they are considered good because they can bring about a number of health benefits that can actually help the health of your gut. Now, these good bacteria can be found in foods such as yogurt and fermented milk, but they can also be sold by companies in the form of tablets or sachets. In general, they are safe to take, but as mentioned in the beginning of this video, if you are thinking about taking them, then make sure you check with a dietitian before you do so. Now, the way in which probiotics work is by once they reach your gut, they compete for space in your gut with the so-called bad bacteria that's already there. It's not just the space they compete with, but for food as well. The more good bacteria there are in your gut, the more they can multiply in number and so lessen the number of the bad bacteria in your gut. Now, these bad bacteria, they use prebiotics as a food source. Now, prebiotics are basically carbohydrates that are poorly digested by our digestive system. Right, so now we know what pro and prebiotics are and how they work. So let's take a look at how they actually relate to Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Now, for probiotics, there is a very limited evidence on this. And so the effectiveness of probiotics in IBD is actually inconclusive. So we don't know if they are actually beneficial to people with Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. Now, when taking medications such as antibiotics, you can experience diarrhea to the changes that the medication is making to the balance of the bacteria in your gut. Now, it's been suggested that some probiotics can actually help prevent diarrhea when on antibiotics. But again, like with anything, if you're taking medication or thinking of changing your diet, please make sure that you refer yourself to your doctor, who can best guide you in these processes. Also, there is evidence that probiotics can help in easing constipation, and that some probiotic drinks that do contain Lactobacillus casei and Lactobacillus bulgaricus could possibly help in preventing infections from Clostridium difficile, or also known as C. diff, in people staying in hospitals and on antibiotics. Now, prebiotics, essentially what you can say is that prebiotics are the indigestible parts of the foods we eat. Now, what you need to remember is everyone with IBD will react differently to different foods. And so some people avoid certain foods because the indigestible parts of what they can eat end up being part of a reaction called fermentation. Now, fermentation is where the bacteria in our large intestines or in our colon use the undigested parts of our food as food for themselves. And while those bacteria are eating that source of food, they do produce gas, which can cause symptoms like bloating and diarrhea, hence why you may get symptoms if you eat what's known as your trigger food. And that's pretty much a brief summary on probiotics and prebiotics in IBD. Now, as I mentioned, I've done this free nutrition guide on IBD, which explains a lot more about prebiotics and probiotics, as well as food and IBD in general. So the way you can download that is by clicking the link in the description box below. Now, make sure you check out these videos on more useful tips, tricks, and information on Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this. And I can't wait to see you all in the next episode.